I said in my last video that I was gonna make a video talking about, you know, my past and stuff like that, so where do I start, really? It's kind of hard to... It's a good place to start this story. As a kid, I always, like, wanted validation from people. Like, I always wanted to be liked and everything. It went from, like, elementary school, middle school, high school. It just never really stopped that, you know, mindset of wanting to be liked by every single person around me. I think when it really got bad was when I went to go see my father in New York. Me and my dad didn't have a really good relationship at all, to be honest. Like, we were just two different people, and I wanted to fix that. So one summer I asked my mom, could she bring me to... Well, not bring me, could she talk to my dad so that they can arrange for me to go to New York so I can be with him for the summer? And, you know, everything was, like, done in, like, days. So now I'm in New York with my dad. When I get there, everything is, like, upside down. Like, he's now talking to my brother and sister that are up there. Everything at home is just odd. And I spent my entire summer fixing it all. And I finally did. Like, I was happy. I completed everything that I needed to do over there. I hung out with my brother and sister. Everybody was happy. It was the day before I was supposed to come back to Florida where he came into the room, my room, and he was just like, we're gonna go get my haircut. Like, he's gonna, you know, go to the barbershop and stuff like that. And all I remember was asking, wherever we're going, do they do mohawks? Because at the time I had a mohawk. And this dude goes off and he's just like, I'm a child and he's an adult, I'm not supposed to be asking him questions and a whole bunch of stuff. And it was just like back and forth between me and him. I forgot how, but we ended up like pushing each other. And then I went downstairs, he stayed upstairs, but I can hear him yelling from upstairs, like, if I pushed him too hard, like, out the window, because I at a certain point I pushed him and my bed is like next to a window, and he's like, if I pushed him out the window, that he would have killed me. So I have my dad's temper. So I'm downstairs pacing back and forth, thinking. And then I'm just like, since he said that he's going to kill me, if I push him out the window, so I go in the kitchen, I get a knife, and I put it, like, in the pillow behind me. Now, this sounds kind of suspect. I'm going to continue the story. So finally, his wife comes, and she's just like, what's wrong? And then he's just like, don't listen to that, you know. He called me a certain name. But he was like, don't listen to him. And she's like, what happened? And I'm explaining the story. He's explaining the story. The stories are not, you know, in sync at all. And so I get even more upset. So I'm just like, since you said that you're going to kill me if I push you out the window, here's the knife. So I put the knife on the coffee table. And then he literally runs towards the knife, grabs it, and tries to stab me with it. But luckily, his wife, like, slapped it out of his hand, and she told me just to go outside. Now, I don't want to be there, and my shoes are upstairs, so I, like, walk all the way to my brother and sister's house, which was, like, 30 minutes away from their house, walking distance. And the whole entire time, it's like, I kind of just shut down. Like, everything about me just shut off. And I didn't cry or anything, but the minute I stepped into their house, I was like, I broke down crying. Like, I could not stop crying whatsoever. It just, I had to call my mom. I explained to her the entire story. My brother and sister's mom made me go back with this guy to go get my stuff. And while we were leaving, my dad was just like, to never talk to him again, that he basically disowned me, that I'd be nothing, and a whole bunch of stuff. And it was just really bad, and I never talked to my dad again after that day. And then later on, I found out that he was telling people that I'm the one that tried to stab him. And for a very long time, I didn't think that whole situation bothered me until later down on the road. And I realized I was not working in school at all. Like, let's start from, like, high school, like, ninth grade year. Like, I was skipping class all the time. And I just did not want to be in school. I was always sleeping and just, like, in my mind, without even realizing what he said about me not being nothing, because without him being in my life bothered me more, and I just didn't want to do anything. And I also surrounded myself around very negative and suicidal people, and I think that kind of rubbed off on me. It's just now end up being suicidal. Like, at a certain point, I couldn't get out of my head. Like, it was so bad. Like, nothing, no one can say, nothing I did was making me happy at all. Like, I remember this one day, it's like everything about me just shut down, and I decided to get in my car, drive all the way to the beach, where there's a pier, and I can't really swim. So I decided to go at the edge of the pier, and I jumped off. All I remember was everything, like, going completely black, and then there was nothing. Next thing I know, I woke up on the shore, and I was, like, crying. So I'm just, like, not because I was even upset about why I did it. It was because I was like, why did I even do this to begin with, you know? Like, what point in my life did I get to the point where, like, ending my entire existence was the solution? So, it was just, I'm still struggling with a lot of things, a lot of bad decisions that I've made throughout the time since that incident. I consider myself to be broken, but I'm not incapable of being fixed. Everybody, wow, that is a loud plane. Everybody goes through things, but I don't ever think that suicide is a solution for it, to be honest. Just find someone that can help you. Find something that makes you happy. Like, I'm not saying I'm happy, but I'm content with life. You know, I'm doing things that actually make me happy. I mean, not happy, but it makes me go through the day. Like, I actually, for the past week, I can say I've been waking up pretty good, if I'm being completely honest. So, I don't know. I made a lot of bad decisions. Things I really do regret. And I really wish that I could take back. I hurt a lot of people. And I really wish that I didn't. A lot of people that I wish I still had in my life, but I did what I did, and now they're gone. They're living their best lives from what I can see, so I'm happy for them. But me, I'm pretty good, you know? I'm trying to do this more YouTube thing more often, trying to talk. You know, I'm gonna start vlogging and do cool stuff. I'm planning, like, this really cool beach trip soon, so I'll vlog that video. So, thanks for watching this somewhat version of a background story about me, just a little bit. I'll share more along the way, but this is just, like, something that I feel like I really needed to say. And to anyone that I did actually hurt, I want to say I'm sorry. It really wasn't my intention. I'm doing better. I'm trying to be a better person.